the core and the guiding of a cylinder of the fiber having a refractive index of m1, that is 1.5, and m2 is equal to 1.4. Here, the m1 is the refractive index of core, and m2 is the refractive index of the cladding. From these two values, m1 and m2, of the core and the cladding of an optical fiber, we have to calculate the critical angle at the core cladding point. And then we have to calculate the acceptance angle of the fiber. Let's solve A part. The critical angle, you know the formula for the critical angle, that is sine pi c is equal to the refractive index is equal to the refractive index of m2 gamma, the refractive index of m2. Here, the refractive index of m2 is 1.4 and the refractive index of m1 is 1.5. When you divide this value with this, you get it is 0.93. It means that sine of the critical angle is equal to 0.93. We need only critical angle, that is sine pi c, then you can write this equation as like this. Sine pi c is equal to sine inverse of 0.93. Now, you have to see this value in log table in which you have to use the sine table. Then you get 68.96 dB. The critical angle at core cladding interface is 68.96 dB. Now we have to calculate the acceptance angle. The formula for acceptance angle is sine I maximum is equal to root of n1 square minus n2 square. Sine I maximum is equal to n1 square. N1 is 1.5 square minus n2 is 1.4 square, then sine I maximum is equal to, when the square is 1.5 and 1.4 value, you get 2.25 minus 1.96. Then sine I maximum is equal to, when you subtract 2.25 value with 1.96, you get 0.29. Then sine I maximum, the root of this value, it gives you 0.5385. Now we need only I maximum, that is acceptance angle, then this equation can be the best. I maximum is equal to the sine inverse of 0.5385. Look at this value in the log table. In the log table, we have to use the sine table. Then we get the corresponding angle, that is 32.58 degrees. So this is the acceptance angle in the optical fiber of cylinder. The second problem is calculate the numerical aperture and hence the acceptance angle for an optical fiber given that the refractive indices of the core and the cladding are 1.45 and 1.40 respectively. In this problem, you have to calculate the numerical aperture and the acceptance angle. Sure. As studied in the previous video regarding you get 2.105. When the square 1.4 value, you get 1.96. Numerical aperture is equal to root of. When you subtract 2.10 with 1.96, you get 0.13. Then numerical aperture of root of this value, you get 0.374. This is the numerical aperture of the optical fiber. Now we have to calculate the acceptance angle. That acceptance angle is nothing but sin I maximum is equal to root of N1 square minus L2 square. Sin I maximum is equal to root of N1 square minus L2 square. This value is already calculated in the numerical aperture, that is 0.374. You need only the I maximum, that is acceptance angle, then I maximum is equal to sine inverse of 0.374. Then I maximum becomes is equal to 22.18 degrees. So this is the acceptance angle and this is the numerical aperture in this problem. Let's take third problem, that is a fiber cable has an acceptance angle of 30 degrees and a core index of refractive index of 1.4. Now we have to calculate the refractive index of the cable. In this problem, the acceptance angle is given to us, that is 30 degrees, and the refractive index of core, that is N1, is equal to 1.4 is also given to us. Now we have to calculate the refractive index of the cladding, that is N2 value we have to calculate. Solution. The sine I maximum is equal to root of N1 square minus N2 square. Squaring on both sides.
That is 1.71. Take square
you get the refractiveness of the electron, that is N2 is equal to root of 1.7, that is N2 is equal to 1.308, where the refractiveness of the core is 1.4 and the refractiveness of the cladding is 1.308. As we know that in the optical fiber, the refractiveness of the core is always greater than the refractiveness of the cladding. That is, I want value is 1.4 and N2